Every once in a while, I come to the desert. It's a good place to think about stuff. I guess that's why it's such a cliche. Lately, there's something I've been thinking about. It's closure. There's a few things in my past that don't have closure. And that's what I'm thinking about today. I'm thinking about how ultimately cool it would be to go get closure in one of these real life things. Take the camera back, live vicariously, get some closure. I was in band in high school. We were really hot. Well, we thought we were. And the jocks always reminded us that we sucked. And they were probably right. They had names for us like band boys, band queers, band fags. My friends and I always wondered, well, who took showers together? Go figure. After graduation, I go off to this huge Texas college and I take band as an elective. And come to find out, it's this huge, clunky beast. There's no pride, no skill, no decorum. It's just big and loud. I began to skip band and eventually dropped out. I took other music electives, but it's the fizzle out thing that's kept me disturbed. I'm gonna go get closure on this. I'm gonna go back to Waxahachie High School for one marching season. Just band. I'm not gonna take chemistry again. That's what I'm gonna do.
One, two, three, play, two, three. Ding, dun, dun. Bum, 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 bum. Okay? I know it's really slow, but don't do this with your hands. Don't bounce like this. Okay? We want to take that out. This would be three even notes. Y'all getting it figured out over here? Okay. One, two, three, play, two, three. Bum 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 bum.
Boom to tat doom fat dum bum. Bass drums, play that measure where it does that. Boom to click boom boom. One, two, ready and go in. That is cool. You'll get that. Okay, snares play where you go. Dig it to tat. One, two, snares, go forward. You ready to play the solo?
What a good group. I am really impressed by this group. I like it when, like, when we break and stuff and everybody's all kind of happy and joking a little bit and kind of just real loose fun. But then when we go to work, it's real serious, serious business. All right, now, let's learn a couple other things so your section leaders have lots to work on. Section leaders continue to refine all aspects. You're gonna have flanks, you're gonna have mark time, you're gonna have all kinds of drag turns, you're gonna have all kinds of stuff in the show. And so the fundamentals we teach you, they're gonna be used in our show and you have to master them.
I've been working on this for a little over a year now. And I get the sense that my motivation is failing because I get these comments from people, you know, I hear their reaction when I'm talking about this new project and they say, well, what's it about? I say, it's you know, I follow this marching band around and I just, the other end of the line, I just hear, what am I supposed to do with that? No, it's really good. It's really a fun thing.
Who in your head are you trying to please that's when you were a little person?
If you watch a drum corps style show, people are moving in all different directions, but the audience is like, here's the stands. I might have to be playing like this and then have to like turn and do this, and then I might go forward toward them for a while, and then I might hit somewhere and have to be backing up. So there's a whole bunch. I want my sound going to the audience, but man, I've got to fit the drill and move all different directions. I remember being in high school and the first time I saw another band and some kid like moved backwards a little bit. I went like, it's marching backwards. We got to have them marching backwards. And now, you march backwards as much as you march forward.
Better. Still have trouble with measure four and the double time spins. Think about it. Concentrate. What are you going to do in measure four? What are you going to do? Drop. Catch inverted. Pop up. Switch hands. Go to wrist curl. You have to really think ahead.
Calm and dress them and let's play triplet exercise.
Dress set. Dress.
It's 10:33. We should do what we're doing right now 3 minutes ago.
Well, the bees are buzzing in the sky. Summertime.
You know, a lot of bands rehearse at night or at 7 in the morning, and we rehearse right in the heat of the day. And we kind of feed off of that, and I think that helps us, this collective attitude.
Deciding when we're trying and when we're not. And I see a lot of trying right now. Let's keep it that way.
It's 10:19 right now. At 10:30, we're gonna do Peterloo.
First, you take the reed and you have to place it on there.
We're gonna have to get out hand chimes, and we're gonna have to get out crotales and real chimes and stuff and do the beginning.
We're really in debt to Mr. Ailey. If he hadn't come and put us all together and shown us what to do, we'd be sitting here just like.
The routine's gotten much stronger and they're using their brains a lot more. The routine is getting to be not just a mechanical thing, but a brain thing as well, thinking about what their routine is and what's coming next.
But it will be something that will be innovative. I have never seen a marching band or a drum corps use hand chimes outside, and we're going to do that. And plus the concept of the five snare drums on the five concert snare drums we're going to work out.
To where it's not like way up here or like way down there.
10-minute break, find your Peterloo, and we'll start Peterloo.
Do you like it?
All right?
I don't know, there's so many of them. I can't even, what can you do, you know?
What you're doing.
Yeah, I just want to try and deliver.
What you're doing is you're trying to prove to that young person that you used to be that experience that he had was valuable. And you're trying to document it like you would write a book or paint a picture or create a song. It's all art is what you're talking about. Yours is the art of the future. And this is a bit of Americana that will never be again within 10 years or so.
And then you take the ligature and put it on there about to the bottom, and that's when you adjust your reed. Just taught him like that.
How'd you learn to do all that?
Sixth grade, Mr. Cody.
He taught you that?
Yeah.
Okay, nice job. Now, the closer part starts with the bells and hand chimes and this flute quartet thing we have going here. Then everybody else comes in, clarinets and stuff with background at 18.
One
trumpet solo at 18. Back into that kind of thing. We have lots of dynamic swells. Everybody looking at your part, please. From 18, like saxophone.
Trumpets. Here we go. One, two.
I've always wanted to do a show that was basically just one piece of music that had lots of contrasts and maybe kind of told a story. And Peter Lou really fits that bill. Music actually depicts the events in Manchester, England in 1819, peaceful gathering of citizens, rallying together on political reform. And they had a lot of ideals about what should be happening. And evidently, the government sent in troops, cavalry, and they dispersed the crowd. And they could have called it off. They kept pursuing people, and a number of people were killed and injured. Really, the piece is about the triumph of the human spirit, and it cannot be quelled no matter what. And so I like the fact that it tells a story. It's something the kids can grab onto and understand. Hopefully, when the show gets good, we'll be able to communicate that to our audience.
Man, it'd be dangerous if we could count. It would be so dangerous. Okay? Good job. Stand easy.
What? I'm not holding it for everybody.
Yeah, I know.
Who brought that, Michael?
Michael. It's every day Michael brings this stuff. He's very...
I like your shape, man.
He's very awesome person.
Where'd you steal from?
Hey, man. He's concerned about the welfare of others. That and he's charging.
Everybody's doing good. We're all knocking out our fundamentals really well and stuff, and we just improve every day, get our lines better, get in step better, and it's all coming together really well. So it'll be a good season, I think. I think we'll do good. Make it to state. Yes.
It's all possible. It just takes a lot of work and a lot of effort and a lot of time.
How's band going so far?
Fun.
Tell me how it's going.
Good.
Like a complete sentence?
Really good.
What?
That hat really helps?
It does.
Just say that in a full sentence. Please?
No.
Tell me that.
I don't play the good question.
You try and try and try, but really all you can get is the surface.
Well, see, that's because of trust. Quality of relationships is built up over time. Good things happen over a period of time.
I mean, I have totally been trying to make everything better, and just, you know, it's just not working. I don't know what to do anymore. I'm just like, okay, do I just, you know, give up and, you know, just have them think that, you know, I don't care or whatever? Or, I mean, this whole thing's been going on for like, I mean, we've been together for like a year, more than a year, and I mean, you can't throw something like that away. I mean, it's just over one problem that's gone just like
okay,
really
guys,
far.
Let's go!
You're in high school, man. Date people. That's what you need to do. Date people.
Life unfolds, and that's the thing that the concept of the quick fix is not satisfying. You know, that young woman was willing to stay a little bit longer in that relationship because she put a lot of time and commitment into it. And the reason the kids aren't talking to you much deeper is because you're not going to be around. And you're there because you want something from them, and they're not sure what that is. And lots of grown-ups have disappointed this age group by the time they're in high school. A good performance, a good film, a good conversation, a good friendship is all about lots and lots of practice.
Need some guts in our sound here. Let's go. 16. Go. Ready? Hit. There. Good job. Go back. Do it again. Let's go, low brass. Two, set, go.
Good job. Stand easy. Okay. Now let me see you march it backwards once.
Everybody's ready to see it, and I can't get it done because, you know, I feel like I go two steps forward, one step back, trying to please everybody.
Hey, brass, backwards march on your toes, straight legs. Okay, not this. All right, not this stuff. Stand up, lean forward, okay? Nail this. All right? Y'all are basically marching real well.
I want to hear the two buzz.
That's gonna be pretty cool. All right, good job. Stand easy.
So, you feel pretty good right now?
Right now, dude. But you know, there'll be lots of the other too. I'm just happy they're playing real well. You never know if it's gonna go together, for sure, until you get out here and do it. You never know if it's gonna be a total disaster, you know. But I have a lot of faith in these kids. Okay, guys, ready? Hey, man, look at the drum major. You finish that like a count before everybody else. Be right with the band, dude, okay? All right, good job. We had a problem coming back across in the baritones that last move hitting. We got a huge space between BJ and Shannon, okay, coming across. Make sure you move your feet. Good job, do it one more time, we'll take a break. Yeah. A short break. We've had five rehearsals so far, five after school rehearsals, learning drill. We learned our entire first movement, which is actually 75% of the show. It's 35 sets, I think. And we totally shoved that down their throat. And we've been working on the plane in rehearsal during the day, but we haven't played and marched at the same time yet till today. And they're doing real well. They're pretty secure. Of course, the strong players kind of carry it, but it's good. The kids sort of start to get a picture of how it's supposed to sound and go together. Better after 2.5 hours of hard work? Are we better than when we started? I thought y'all worked extremely hard today. Now let me tell you what we have to do tomorrow. We have to review what we just did. Then we have to learn drum feature to the end. Drum feature to the end tomorrow. It's a bunch of stuff, okay? As well, let me remind you of these other things. We have 11 rehearsals till DeSoto. DeSoto is a big deal. Upperclassmen, you need to clue everybody in on what it's about. You're going to go, and there's going to be like bands from all over North Texas, all over the place. And we're there to compete head to head. We want to get in the finals, which means we have to be among the top 10. And then when we get in the finals, we have set a goal of being in the top 5. If we do really good, then we need to pat ourselves on the back and then just keep trying to get better. October 25th is our biggest day. Area contest at Mesquite. That's the big one, okay? There'll be about 20 bands there, and they're going to take the top 3. Last time, we were 4th. Okay? So we want to do our best to get there. You deserve it. But you have to earn it. I'm telling you now, two things I want you to remember. You have to earn it every day. And there's no guarantees. I want you to remember, we could work ourselves to death and we still might not get it. You have to accept that. Accept it. But I am proud of you. I think the show is coming along. I think by the time we get there, it has the potential to be really excellent. There's some variables, such as grades, those type things, but I think you're gonna come through. This band usually comes through for me. You guys totally rocked today. Good rehearsal. Let's have another good one tomorrow. Okay, on your feet, grab a hand. Let's be together.
And guess who sings his lullabies through nights that know no end? My fickle friend, old men pretend. My fickle friend, the summer wind. Summer wind. The summer wind.
You're doing them Wednesday. You're doing them tomorrow.
They're so pumped up right now and excited their first game. As the season wears on, this gets a little bit more routine, and they just know what to do. You know, the first time, it's a big deal. We have inspection before any performance, and usually we set it about 15 minutes before we leave. And so we have time to talk to them a little bit and do that. The buses should get here about 5, and hopefully we'll get there.
Test. Okay, we should be getting all the gloves and all the plumes passed out. While we're doing that, listen carefully. I think that, once again, you guys are doing a great job. On the bus ride, we ride a bus as a mature young adult. Once in a while, we get in a strange town, and maybe there'll be somebody on the street yelling at us, yelling something really ugly. And your reaction is to want to yell back. But what we do is we have class, and we just don't. We just look the other way. Okay, there's one down. Just kidding, she's okay. Section leaders, I want you to check your section and see who does not have a flip folder, a complete flip folder. Some of the ninth graders haven't ever gone anywhere without your mom addressing you and making sure you got everything. This is your first chance to keep track of a whole bunch of stuff. Now, I want to talk to you real quick about what's going to happen when we get there. I'll go, hey man, this looks good. Okay, this will be the front of the band. We're talking the attendance block, okay? Then the drum majors will come and they will get everybody off the buses, everybody. Immediately, the pit, the battery, the color guard go to the trucks and unload the stuff. Pit, you just get the, we've got 3 trailers. Okay, we've got it all hooked up, thanks to Mr. Montgomery. Okay, we've got it all hooked up. We got the tractor, Mr. Stevens be there with you. Take your time, there's no giant hurry. Okay, battery, obviously, we're in a more of a hurry. We need to get like our drums, get all hooked up, and you're gonna play us in, okay? So you'll kind of go off to the side, and you'll play us in, all right? That's a big deal there. Color guard, just get all the stuff loaded, all right? Take your time, don't panic, okay? Stay together, we got a lot of junk, everybody grab something. The tubas will unload, there should be 2 tubas per bus. Bus 6, no tubas.
Yeah.
Guys needs to make sure that we get the podium over there, or see if somebody gets the podium for that side, or put it on the cart, or do something. Linda, I'm gonna need you to help with the French one again, okay, when we walk over here. Okay, man, get your gloves on. We're gonna put them right here, and then we'll figure out, once all these people leave, we'll figure out. I'll talk to you a little more when we get lined up down here. Hurry up and get your gloves on. Okay, everybody up? Okay, flute player, lead off right here. Go. Okay,
this looks pretty bad when you get here. 15, 16, drop two, flat two, up two. We'll try that again. From the contagion up. From the contagion up, you're at angle, we'll go 15, 16.
Check everybody's little strap. This is a 20, that's a 30. You know what yard line you go? So probably what I'm gonna do at the buzzer, I'm gonna tell the band to step out and we'll come out to the goal line like we do in practice, okay? I'll just come out in the field with you right here, it's no big deal. I'm gonna walk out there with you. We're gonna walk out to the goal line, okay? When the buzzer sounds, we're gonna walk out to the goal line, just like we would in practice. I wanna hear clarinet sound when you turn around, clarinet, saxophone sound, and then the flutes. Wait, 48, take off. Hit the lines. Have a what? They look ready over there? Kill it. Bop, 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 bop. All right, let's name it. Tick, tick, tick. Ready, and.
Everybody did a good job, and we didn't fall apart during the halftime show, so that was good. And everybody had a pretty good time, I think, and played pretty well for the first game.
One and play!
You just go out there, you just try to do your best, and they're not going to hate you if you can't just nail it, but, you know, you try to do your best for your own personal and for the rest of the band, too.
It's by far the hardest music and the hardest drill we've ever done here.
It's going to take a while. It's difficult, you know, at first. But once we get the whole thing together, I think it's going to be really neat. I'm hoping that it'll be something really special, you know, that we'll do and can be kind of an emotional experience for both the audience and the student performers.
We still have a lot of drill to learn, and for the rest of the year, the closer, and some changes to make. But I think overall, they're going to do really well. They've got the heart for it, and they've got the determination for it.
To the left, to the left. Turn, 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 stop. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. That's me, Joe. Two, ready, and. Get all this stuff. Go, Pitt. Pitt, go. That way. Yep.
Right now or out?
No, they're going to run. Look right here. Look right here. Okay, for a first game, an outstanding job tonight. It was really hard because we got here late. We had to run in the stands. We had to do all that stuff. Okay, I'm very proud of you. I had nothing but compliments, okay? I want to have a nice, relaxing bus ride. And when we get back, the room's spotless, okay? All right, let's dismiss. Great job tonight, guys. I'm very proud of you. Take your hat box home. Take your uniform home. Take your instrument home. Pick trash up. I want the guard room. Look top notch. I want the drum room. Look top notch. I want the uniform room. Look top notch. Overall, in the context of a first game of the year, they did a really super job. You have to take into account that we had a long way to go. It was hot. We got there late. The setup, like we didn't have room to set up for halftime in the end zone. It was about 10 feet from the back of the end zone to the wall. And so we didn't have time to start room to set up normally. Of course, the show we're doing is very, I mean, the beginning of it's very finesseful, and you have no idea how that's gonna go with a crowd on a foreign field they've never been to before. And so, all that taken into account, they did excellent. We got through the show well. They did well in the stands. They played pretty well. I mean, we still have some problems, just cleanliness of the tunes. So those things, I mean, basically we want to, this gives us a good starting point, and we want to improve each week. We want everything to improve, every aspect of what we do, from playing in the stands to how we carry ourselves to everything. It's interesting, the other director came and talked to us while we were loading the buses, and he just wanted to know, like, how we got the kids to look so good when they played, and just how we were so far along, which was really flattering and nice. You know, it makes you feel good. But to us, there's a lot of things we can still do better, so we'll work on it. I think, by and large, the kids had a good experience, and these little guys, these little ninth graders, that's their first experience. They'll never forget it, you know, so it's kind of cool.
No, I'm going home.
Ultimate team, we have to come together and work really hard to get accomplished what we want done, but at the same time, I view band as a social organization. I mean, it's great fun. I love band. I love the band parties. I love hanging out with people in band, but I love getting down to business and working real hard. September, we could say, is our worst month because we're just cleaning and cleaning and so many repetitions, and it gets boring after a while. Some other classmen, it's way off in the distance to them just because we don't have a concept of how soon it actually is, but when it gets closer to time, the upperclassmen start stressing out, and the freshmen will soon see why we're working so hard.
There's two Carries and two Joels and two Daves in the drum line, and so that one's really interesting because Mr. Ailey will call out one of us is doing something wrong, and all of us, like, either one of us will fix it, and then he tells us, no, not you, the other Carry or the other Dave or the other Joel. We'll be right back.
stuff always happens. You can't plan for everything. Had a French horn player who got conked on the head by a trombone that was standing behind her.
And all of a sudden, I got dizzy, and I fell on Miss Hausman or something, and then I just remember them asking, you know, what's your name, how old are you, and stuff like that. I just kind of remember going into an ambulance, and remember I couldn't feel the left side of my face. When I was laying there kind of wondering what everyone was saying, I was like wondering, you know, did I get blood on my uniform, and if I was going to have to, like, take the uniform to the cleaners the next day.
I've seen a lot of other bands, and the directors aren't half as close to the students as ours are. Our directors know our names, know our strong points, know our weak points. And if you have a problem, you can always go talk to them. Neither of them have, like, kids, and so they consider us their kids, and they spend most of their time that if they had kids, they would spend with them, with us. So they love us like their kids, and it really makes a closer feeling with us, so we feel like we can work with them.
So who are you trying to please from when you were a little person?
You know, my family has no clue what I do. They have absolutely no clue what I do. Here's Duane, he videos. And that's just so not the description. I just say, yeah, I video.
Well, that's the little kid part of you that brought home the report card that was pretty good, except for maybe that B plus.
You think you did good?
Yes.
I think I did good.
I
think that there were some mental errors, like a couple people got out of step a couple times, but basically everybody fixed it whenever it got screwed up, and so it turned out to be pretty good.
Yeah, we fixed it. Got better.
I just feel like I could have done better.
Well, I mean, I was pretty satisfied, but evidently the other bands weren't all impressed as much as we wanted them to because we didn't get a standing ovation.
How do y'all feel after this is over?
I feel
tired.
Good,
but tired.
I feel very relieved, and I feel that tonight, if we make it to the finals, which we probably will, I mean, I'm not saying that conceitedly or anything, but I think we did a good enough job to make it to the finals.
In sixth place, Waxahachie.
One of the things I'm really impressed with is the respect that you show these young people and the fact that in our life, everything is about trying to do something better. And there is that inspirational dissatisfaction. When people fail too much, they stop. And when people succeed too much, the edge comes off of it. So there's that tension. It's each person's individual opinion. All these kids are being judged by human beings. And each one of them had their own preferences. And that's where, in our culture, we've gotten in too much into trying to please outside ourselves.
Let's do it, guys. Okay, drums, we got a minute 30.
The next band in class 4A is the Spirit of Waxahachie High School Band from Waxahachie, Texas. Is your band ready?
Region 20, UIL Marching Contest.
Drum majors,
good luck to your
performance. You may begin competition in the UIL Region 20 Class 4A Marching Band Contest.
Check the stick height there, percussion.
The we're not close.
Yeah, okay, good. We're off now. Okay, good. We're off now. Come on, down front. Your interval. Clarinet player, right on 35. Your interval. You gotta just switch it. Yeah, get up on your toes, keep your feet together.
together here.
Cover down. Cover.
You know, it's not Hollywood. We're not working in Hollywood.
No, this is real life.
It'll sound kind of weird, but it makes me feel good to see so many sad faces, because that shows how much you care about our group. But we got to get over it, you know? That's part of it. This is life right here. Feel it. Soak it up. Sometimes stuff does not go the way you want. I am so proud of you, okay? Y'all came in fifth. You were right there, okay? Really strong. The show was awesome. You've been awesome all year. You have nothing to hang your head about. You can be sad because you wanted to go on, but you have nothing to hang your head about. We've talked every bit about this, okay? This kind of stuff draws a group close together, okay? And we need to endure this kind of stuff. Y'all poured your hearts and soul into the show, and I know that. And your directors did, the parents did. There were no more awesome parents and fans there than we had. And everybody's proud of you. I love you guys, man. I love you guys for everything you've done. You are awesome. Let's dismiss right here and get on a bus.
What kind of circumstances? I love doing this so much. This has been my life for the past 4 years, man. I'm gonna miss it, man. I just love the smell of that gasoline on these buses, man. Diesel smell. It's great to me. Brings back memories to me. It's kind of ironic, but yeah, I'm gonna miss it a whole lot.
Tonight, the rest of your life, regardless of what you take away from here. We have worked so hard to get to this point, and I want you to know that Peter Lou does not die here tonight. Peter Lou lives on, and the effort that you take and the things that you have learned about yourself, that is what's really important about tonight. I am so proud of all of you and the effort that you've given, and you have nothing to hang your head about. Thank you.
Talked about in the beginning using a word from my field, bringing closure, which is an individual person's sense of everything falling in place. And do you feel that way as you watch the end of this?
Well, I feel the whole experience has been a personal success. I can look back on this now and say everything has fallen into place abruptly at times, but in the end it did. My visual essay starts wrapping up here, but the evolution of the story continued. The Peterloo show was never performed again. The group finished out the football season with a more generic approach.
Give me an N.
And like all high school bands, began working on holiday music in their upcoming concert. A state marching contest was held and, ironically, won by the Poteet Pirates. Ironic because it was seeing this band rehearse 4 years ago that gave me the idea to go back to Waxahachie. I check in occasionally. David Cody and Paul Ailey still do their thing.
Vaughn Hausman went on to teach in another district with her husband, and Bill Sintera left town unannounced shortly before the school year ended. I made a number of attempts to reach out, but never heard from him again. So Liz and I talked about how and why this could happen with him. She said that's not unusual.
Because this gentleman spent an awful lot of his away time, and he poured a lot of creative energy into the kids. And a lot of times people who do that kind of work don't then take care of themselves. And for whatever reason, sometimes they develop, you know, high blood pressure, or they have family problems or something as a result of trying to restore themselves so they can go back and, you know, take care of all of those little individual people. He, in his day, heard about romances, about breakups, about kids being sick, about parents being mean. He took in a lot of information and was a mentor to a lot of people and was there, and there rarely is, provided for him a way for him to talk and restore. And so whatever his personal reasons were that kept him from continuing on, I'm not surprised, because he gave so much of himself.
I was at the school the day after he left, and the look on those kids' faces. Obviously, Bill had given a lot. But as Liz said, life unfolds. Every individual I met on this endeavor has given me something more refreshing to look back on. Perhaps I got a little too close to the story. But after all, that was the intent. Ooh, yeah!
Taken out in forever.
What's, are these little notes?
Hey, I was looking for this.
What follows is the battle between citizen and soldier.
Let's put a little bit more tape on it, it'll be fine. Come to a football game, you gotta have tape.
I don't know how. Thank you. Hey,
look, cool.
Tar.
It's tar from the parking lot.
Really get into the show and everything. Laura, shut up. Don't put that on there.
I know how you do.